Okay, welcome everybody to the Black Flash Promotions show from Withenshaw Forum today. I'm Aki Kareem and I'm joined in the commentary position by Mr. Dan Murray. How are you, mate?
Yeah, very well, Aki. How about yourself?
All good, looking forward to this one. We've got Ryan Oliver in there. He's going in there with Willie Warburton. And we all know what Willie Warburton's about. You've got to be on your game to beat him.
Yeah, absolutely. But I think it's a fight that Ryan's going to look well in. He had an impressive stoppage last time. He's been down Champions Camp sparring recently and all reports are he's been looking very well.
That's right, they're just doing the formalities as we speak. No ring music tonight, throwing it back to the old school, Dan. I know you like a bit of old school business, don't you?
I do, I'm an old school kind of guy. I think they could have got you singing the people in the country.
Yeah, they could have done, mate. I would have been up for it. Now, Ryan Oliver, as you said there, he's coming off a 29-second win by a body shot, you know, which gave him a lot of confidence. And he's been looking good in training for this one.
He has, yeah. I didn't see him sparring down at Champs Camp, but he was sparring Taz. And Taz was saying really good things about him and actually said that he's punching well to the body. But I think he's made massive improvements since he's gone over to Rune. And I think it's showing now. I think we talk about the body shots, but not only that, I think he's using his jab a lot better as well nowadays.
Yeah, when he throws shots he never used to throw, he's got the stabbing jab to the, as I say it there, he throws it. He's much more sort of calm and controlled in the ring as well.
Yeah, he is. Yeah, he looks very confident. He looks very relaxed. And like you say, that jab to the body is a very, very effective one. Willie's a tough man, though. He's been there. He's seen it all. And I think it'd be a very, very good experience just for Ryan.
Well, the thing about Willie is he's actually more elusive than people realise.
Yeah.
He's very hard to tag clean.
Yeah. And that's why it's vital to use a jab against him. You're probably not going to get your fancy big shots off against him. I think you just have to use your jab and kind of pick your shots very careful. I like this from Ryan. He's nice and relaxed and he's taking his time. Just measuring up with that jab.
Needs to keep his wits about him because Willie does throw unorthodox shots, out of nowhere, as we'll probably see in the later rounds as well.
Yeah, I think so. I think Ryan, he can't get too confident in there and he can't switch off because, yeah, if you leave yourself open against someone called Willie, someone like Willie, you're gonna pay for it. Just noticing your voice there, Aki, sounds a bit croaky. you got a cold?
I've actually been on my stag do last night, mate, so...
Oh yeah,
it is what it is.
Whose stag do was that, mate?
That's mine. And
you're getting married.
I am indeed.
Not
taking
sure
the plunge.
Not sure how you've pulled that one off, getting someone to marry you, but. But there's someone for everyone, apparently.
That's the one, mate. And tonight we're the dream team. And Ryan's doing a good job in there. He's just holding the centre of the ring. He's not taking any risks, just boxing nicely behind the jab.
I just noticed he's been missing a little bit to the head with the right hand, but Willie's experience, he's just leaning out of the way. So I think Ryan just needs, after he jabs, just get his feet up a little bit, and then I think the right hand will land. Nice.
I like the right hand to the body there.
Do you know what? He's got a good array of body shots now. He's got the straight jab, the straight right, and when he's inside, he's just turning them up very nicely.
It's important to have a good variation of body shots, isn't it, Dan?
Yeah, I mean, you can't just have the one body shot. Body punching, there's an art to it, I think. And I think you need to find the openings, and if they're not there, you need to find them. You need to make them. Good first round there for Ryan. This is the sort of experience that's going to hold him in good stead for the future.
Out. Round two. Okay, here we go, round number two. I think Ryan sort of cruised through the first round there, didn't he, picking up the round. Be good to see Willie engage a little bit here so we can find out a bit more about what Ryan's about, because I know he's really has got it in his locker these days.
Yeah, one thing about Ryan, what I didn't mention in the first round, is how physically strong he's looking nowadays. You can actually see his body shape almost changing. I know he trained very hard down at heavy hitters.
Yeah, it's a good point you mentioned there, actually, because he used to have sort of like a boy's frame, didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
He's now got a solid muscular frame.
Yeah. But I think you're right what you say about Willie. You'd like to see him engage a little bit, wouldn't you? Maybe test Ryan a little bit at times.
He's so elusive, though. You know, he's got that lean-back style to get out of the way of shots, so it can be frustrating to be in there with Willie.
Yeah.
Got to really just maintain your composure.
And if Willie does start to engage, I think it's careful for it's sensible for Ryan to stick to his boxing and not get involved.
Put a few good shots together there. Set him up nicely. What I like, though, he was always balanced and in control all the way through.
Yeah. Nice. Just want to see Ryan faint maybe a bit more. Faint before he comes in with it.
So, you know, obviously as a trainer yourself, Dan, you know, when you're teaching your fighters to throw the feints, what are you trying to do? Induce an opening? You know, sort of make them make a mistake?
Yeah, I mean, what you can do, there's many different reasons to throw a feint. Sometimes it's just to keep your opponent busy. Not let they might be setting you up for something, so if you can feint them, you sort of like what my old trainer say, break the picture up. So and also then you're looking for a reaction out of the fighter as well, so you can throw a feint and you might notice that the fighter's dropping his right hand, he's dropping his left hand or the openings, but generally it's just to kind of keep your opponent busy, not let him know what's coming.
Good little stabbing shot there to the body, set it up nice. He blinded him with the left hand, didn't he, and then just threw that little
he is very impressive
shot
to the body.
I think he sees it as a bit of a strength of his now.
Yeah.
You know, the body work.
I think he's got a good balance because quite often with fighters, young fighters coming through as well, when they start throwing nice body shots and they start having a bit of success, they forget the rest of the game and they go kind of body hunting. But what Ryan's doing is he's working behind the jab fantastically and he's being very patient. He's only throwing the body shots when they're there. He's not going out of his way to find them.
That's a good shot there. The left hook to the body was a nice one.
It's a very dominant performance so far.
Good round that from Ryan. Very good round.
Time is 10 seconds. 7 seconds out. Round 3.
Okay, here we go into round number 3. I don't think there's any doubt that Ryan's picked up the first two rounds here. Some good body work. Some nice ring control. Liking what you see, Dan?
Yeah, it's been a clinical performance so far. I think he's worked fantastic off the jab, and when he's been in close, he's worked the body well, and he's picking his shots fantastically. Just want to see more of this, really. I don't think he's ever going to get Willie out of there. He's such a tough man, Willie.
Yeah.
So I think it's just kind of keeping your composure and keeping your concentration as well.
Now, Ryan's had some very, very class sparring in the recent years. I mean, he's been in with people like Terry Flanagan, Jack Catterall. He's, you know, he's one of them guys who, you know, he likes to get in the mix, and actually, it's really, you can tell in the ring, those encounters have really brought him on.
Yeah, sparring's vital, and I think you're seeing it now, the way he's so relaxed, he's picking his shots. I mean, like you said, if he's sparring people like Terry Flanagan, that's top class sparring. It's going to be very tough. So when he gets in the ring now, he's going to be filled with an air of confidence.
Yeah, definitely.
Nice jab to the body again.
I mean, as a trainer yourself, Dan, as well, when you're working with fighters, how important is sparring in the camp?
The right sparring is very important. I mean, sparring in general, I mean, you can take it or leave it, but quality sparring is vital. It's the closest thing you're going to get to fighting, and it's going to bring you on. I think what you want is you want someone... you want to spar someone who's going to bring you on, someone that's slightly ahead of you. You don't need no gym wars. I think that takes too much out of a fighter. But I think it's where you do most of your learning. What I'd like to see now with Ryan is I want a controlled performance from him, but I also want him to go through the gears a bit.
Yeah, I was just about to say that. It would be nice to see him just sort of stepping in, and he is actually as we speak.
Yeah.
Throw a little bit more leather, that's it.
that's what you want, because Willie wants to go into his own pace. Willie just wants to go through the kind of motions and get through the fight. But Ryan, you're looking for him to really make Willie earn his money.
Yeah, and Willie, I'd said it at the beginning, Willie comes back with flurries at you know, times we don't expect it.
Yeah.
Now, did he slip there, or was that a genuine knockdown? I didn't really.
I think he was off balance.
Yeah. Well, it's been counted regardless.
Yeah.
And not many people put Willie Warburton down, did they? And he's going to dine out on that now for years, Ryan.
He'll buy the copyrights to the footage, not let anyone see it.
Well, I think Willie's only been stopped twice in his entire career, and once was a technical decision. So, yeah. Knowing Ryan like I do, he'll probably just put that very little clip on Instagram.
Every week for the next 10 years. Yeah.
Fourth and final round. We're at Withenshaw Forum for the Black Flash promotion show. A good little first fight. I mean, we've seen some good things there from Ryan Oliver's for him to take back and work on in camp as well.
Yeah, I think so. I think it's been a clinical performance. It's been good. I mean, where do you think Ryan goes from here? Do you think he's going to want to step up soon?
Yeah, I believe he does. I think he wants to go, you know, 6 and 8 rounds.
Yeah.
I think he's ready for a step up. You know, his last couple of performances have been really impressive, to be honest with you. And it would be nice to see him in there, maybe some local boys or certainly someone that's going to come with a bit of fire and ambition to test him, you know. And I think he's ready for it, mate.
Yeah, I think he's ready for it. I think that's what he needs as well. I think he's cruised through these 4 rounds so far. And I think he probably needs a little step up now. And I think what you'll see of him, I think the better the opponent, the better he'll perform as well.
Yeah, I think we will see that. I mean, he did have that loss early in his career, but he'll tell you himself, he didn't. He wasn't in the right headspace that week leading up to that fight, and I think actually we've discussed in the past, just off the record, that he might, you know, that, you know, the rematch, because at the end of the day, people respect you for taking those rematches against people you lost to, don't they?
Absolutely. I think he'd really fancy it as well. No, I mean, no disrespect to like Stevie Bell, who he's training with, but I always got the impression they were mates. They were kind of mates having a go. Arun, I've known Arun for 20 odd years. I know how serious he takes his boxing, and I know how hard all his fighters train. And I think you're seeing it with the likes of John Telford. Obviously Jordan's doing well, and now you're seeing it with Ryan Oliver. I think he's showing vast improvement. And I think you're quite right. If he goes for the rematch, if he gets it, I think he'll fancy it. And I think I'd fancy him as well to overturn it.
And you mentioned Stevie Bell there. He's a top man, because he actually, you know, was so good about, you know, saying to Ryan, go on to heavy hitters to sort of carry on with your career. And
yeah,
I always say, you know, that's like a true friendship, isn't it, really?
Yeah, absolutely. Miss Stevie Bell, I mean, I remember watching him as a kid. Fantastic fighter. Yeah, brilliant he was.
So good stuff here from Ryan, setting up the right hand over the top with the body shots.
Nice.
Digging him in, he's liking his work at the minute, isn't he? He's enjoying it.
Yeah, I think against someone who isn't as tough as Willie, I think these will have an effect. And that's why I want to see him in the longer fights, because I think he'll really take its toll on his fighters. I think he'll get quite a few stoppages later.
I can see him taking people out with these body shots, to be honest.
Yeah, I think so. I think when he starts stepping up to 6-8 rounds, possibly 10, I think he'll start wearing his opponents down.
I mean,
and
you
stopping
need a
them.
Sledgehammer to take out Willie Warburton, it's simple as that.
Yeah. And even then, you probably need two.
Yeah.
One would probably break on his head.
You might need Thor's hammer. You know, Thor's hammer, that would do the trick, wouldn't it? It's one bombing with Thor's hammer.
Or an Aki right hand
That's
might
it,
do
mate.
The trick.
Nice combination work here from Ryan.
And you just see there, when he's in close air, he's throwing him with bad intentions. I like that.
Very good.
Very, very valuable 4 rounds there.
Time scales.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for the fighters in this very first round this evening. Come on, let's give it up for them, ladies and gentlemen.
out. Your referee has decided that the winner by 40 to 36 is, in the blue corner, Mr. Ryan Oliver. And let's hear it, please, ladies and gentlemen, for his opponent, Mr. William Warburton. Thank you so much for you.
Yeah, it's a washout there for Ryan, like we thought it would be. It's a very, very valuable four rounds from there. And now him and his team of rude and heavy hitters can move on from that. Very impressive.
Right, I'm here with the winner, Ryan Oliver. Ryan, good performance there, mate. Good body work and all that sort of stuff. You happy with it?
Yeah, I'm happy. Listen, Willie's all respect to Willie. He's the toughest of tough, innit? So, yeah, pleasure to share the ring with him and feel like it was a good performance. He said to me at the end that, you know, I'm a good kid. So, if Willie Warburton says that, he's been in with some of the best, hasn't he? So, you're laughing.
Did you drop him there as well?
No. I want to put it out there. It wasn't a knockdown. I thought, he's going to come and get me now. I stunned his foot.
But we will see that clip on Facebook and Instagram for the rest of his life.
No rematch then.
Yeah. So basically, though, talk us through some of the improvements there, mate, because honestly, you look really controlled. And, overall, I'm not just saying it, it was a real good performance.
Thanks, mate. Yeah, obviously, last time out, I got a quick win. And I knew that weren't going to happen with Willie. You'd have to be stupid to expect that. So I just went in, stuck through boxing. Make sure I didn't do anything silly, get caught with, yes mate, all right. Make sure I didn't get caught with any daft shots and just hurt the body loads because he's very evasive to the head, so yeah. All right, I'm happy.
Fair enough, and mate, I think we're all looking forward to a step up in the next couple of fights for you. I think you're ready, mate, aren't you?
Thank you very much, yeah, I think so. Get to 10 fights then we'll really be, you know, challenging some serious things hopefully, so yeah, thank you.
Well, mate, the next fight's on, but top one, enjoy your night now. Take care. Don't look at my face, please. I'm too hungover.
Thank you, mate. Thank you.
See you later. Nice one. All right, man.